It was roughly 10%, wasn't it?
Yeah, at the time it was 10%. And I'm hoping at this point that we may be able to reduce that. But this was going in.
I wouldn't count on it.
Well, at least on the steel. I mean, if it comes in on contract, that's a big ticket item.
Sure.
So we can, you know,
it would help us.
Reduce contingency as things are brought in on budget, but keep it for the other items.
Yeah, the big thing is gonna be getting the contractor here on site and getting started and seeing if he encounters any hurdles upfront.
Is that the discussion we're in, is just the trestle in general? Sorry.
Well, capital, but that's really the only thing that's happened since the last meeting. Anything that's in terms of change, the rest of the projects are all shut down for the winter.
Right.
Pretty much looked at all of those in the December meeting. They're all the other projects. The Osier Section House Foundation is on budget and will get finished up in June when they're able to get back into Osier and get the painting and the final touch ups accomplished on it. But that project's within budget.
The original budget?
Yes. Okay. All the funds available.
Is it worth mentioning any of the potential problems we've got with the DOT?
Yeah, that's a good, you know, on timing.
Well, I mean, I think we ought to
sure
be pretty
upfront
and open about that.
Yeah, the joint powers agreement is signed by the highway department. It is now at the Department of Finance and Administration and awaiting signature either of the cabinet secretary or his designee.
Well, it's actually got all the signatures on it. Highway department, federal, and district engineer.
Randy's is
the commission. I sign on behalf of the commission, the two legal signatures, but it's we've got to have the Department of Finance and Administration signature on it. And I keep looking at this because the secretary is supposed to call me back and confirm that he will get it signed by Friday, because if we don't get this executed by Friday, it could delay the contract award for 30 days. Mm. So, which would be a killer.
Yes.
So, I've been in touch with the Lieutenant Governor's office, and his chief of staff spoke to the secretary yesterday. And we have no reason to think there's a problem getting it signed. It's just the Department of Transportation indicated to us that in the past they've been able to just walk things over and get them signed, and in this administration they were unable to do that. And so we just wanted to be sure, because we can't afford a 30-day lag on letting the contract. So that's and if the contract is awarded by Friday, the completion date of May 15th is still a solid date. Obviously if it slid 30 days, it wouldn't be. So that's one issue. And the other issue, we want to talk about that one, is there's a discrepancy right now as to whether the 25, when we met with the Department of Transportation, the 25% required match, remember there was $1.1 million or $1.2 million that was awarded, there was a 25% match, $825,000 being provided by the Department of Transportation and $275,000 by other funding from the owner, the commission. And we were very clear with the Department of Transportation that our match was going to be in the purchase of the steel. And they said, yeah, that's fine. So we said, we've got to go ahead and purchase the steel now in order to get it on site in time to have the trestle open. And they said, that's fine. Now they've suggested to us that the $825,000 contract for the construction requires a 25% component from the commission, and that the steel doesn't serve as a match. And I mean, that's, correct me if there's anything exactly wrong in this, because some of this I'm getting third hand.
Yes.
So the Department of Transportation has agreed to go to the feds and say they purchased the steel, is it okay for that to be the match? And the hurdle we have there is the federal government doesn't like allowing something that happened after the fact that we went ahead and did the contract. But we did the bids for the steel in total compliance with how the state and the federal government would have done the bids. But that little issue is up in the air.
Yeah.
Now, clearly, we can't hold up, and I've, Rhonda Fought, who's the former Secretary of Transportation, is working with us on a pro bono basis to help us facilitate any problems that we run into, and apparently she knew we would, we have. And but as I advised her just yesterday, we won't allow that issue to hold up the construction. If we were to have to come up with another $175,000 or $180,000, we'd find a way to do that. And that's why I say the contingency, we can't look at that as money we're going to get back. This all will get resolved very shortly, but we've got to move ahead with the contract and fight about the issues later if that is what has to be done. So we've just, you know, everything looks easy, and you know, they gave us $1,000,001, and then we find out it wasn't $1,000,001, it was $825,000, and now we're finding out the $825,000 might be six something, and you know, it just, we keep running into that. The other part would be anything that we haven't spent yet. There's another $125,000 or $150,000 commitment I think that we need to make in the whole budget. We would look to the state to put in 75% of that. So that would be a way that we might be able to recoup a part of that as well. So I don't think there's a problem, but it's just clearly we need to be upfront that there are some issues that,
yes,
that come about when you deal with bureaucracy.
And
which
Department
we are a part
of transportation
bureaucracy. We are bureaucracy.
So. Yeah. So that's one of the reasons I've tried to keep the higher contingency in here at the moment as well.
But absolutely.
Allow for some.
We shouldn't let that go until we get locomotive runs across mm-hmm. that trestle.
Yeah.
No, I agree. Mm-hmm. I just wanted to make sure that we were.
Yeah.
There was method to your contingency madness.
There is, unfortunately. It's fine. I wish I could lower it, but
no. I just wanted to make sure we were.
Yeah. But overall, in terms of projects, we are within budget, and even the trestle project is within the $2 million that we looked at as the budget going into this. So we're within that scope of work. And,
Mr. Chairman, I just like to add that I don't want to make it sound like the Department of Transportation isn't being cooperative with us in every way possible. They have expedited this project. We've got a really good project manager that we're working with, and he is 100% supportive of and understands the need for us to hit this completion date. So the Department of Transportation is being very cooperative. It's just when you're dealing with the funds are actually federal funds coming through the state, and you get all these entities involved in it, it gets a bit complicated.
Thank you, Commissioner Randall. Do you have some additional reports?
No, unless there's any other questions on the capital portion of it.
I just have one request, you know, kind of since we are in, can we get a, you know, kind of an updated, maybe on a monthly basis, where we are on the trestle budget and materials and, you know, just to kind of keep tabs with that.
Maybe I think we ought to get it weekly.
Well, that's fine.
Because 2 months is going to be too late.
Well, I know. That's right.
Let's distribute it every week.
Please.
Thank you, Leo. Great recommendation.
Good thought.
Leo, anything else?
We're not there yet, so I kind of always kind of scared to talk about it. But with the $200,000 right now on the, you know, the capital development on the capital side in the state of Colorado, is that strictly for track work or is it track and trestle?
I think it has flexibility in it. The only problem is that funding wouldn't become available until July 1.
Okay.
So at that point, trestle by and large should be complete, but you know, if we need to do some cleanup work or final touch-up.
But it's not restricted in that matter.
I think
as long as it's on the,
it has flexibility to it. Yes.
Okay. Good. Thank you.
So if we could find, if we did run short, if we could find other cash to get us through,